Baptist Church. Listen, on behalf of myself and my dear wife, Dr. Kimara Weeks, we'd like to welcome you to this awesome, awesome cyber campus. Today we're going to be celebrating our global communion service. Yes, today we're going to commune with hundreds of thousands, maybe millions of people, breaking the body of Jesus Christ and drinking the blood of our Lord and Savior. Also on this awesome day is the second week of our Sunday morning revival series, and we are so excited that our speaker is none other than Dr. Derrick Mercer. Listen, so I ask you to stretch your hands towards the screen. As I stretch my hands towards you as we open up in prayer, we'll have two awesome selections from this music ministry, followed by our communion service, and then the word for today. You ought to get excited because God is already about to change something in your life. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come to you with open hearts, open minds, thanking you for being who you are. Thanking you for your anointing that is flowing into this building already, oh God. Let it flow out through our cyber campus to each and every person that is watching us this morning. And God, as we get ready to take your communion, God, let healing be the children's bread, God. Let bodies be healed. Let testimonies flow in of cancer and tumors being eradicated. We thank you right now for being who you are. Have your way in this service. God, we bless you and we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand clap. The marvelous thing to do is a marvelous rise. Hallelujah. I don't know that can't nobody do it like you. Come on, let's go.
Thank you.
those of you that are joining us around the world for our communion service, we are about to begin with the sacred ordinance of the church.
Yes.
Along with baptism, this is one of the rituals of our faith. Jesus said, as often as you do this,
yes, amen,
do this in remembrance of me. One of the things that Jesus said also in the Gospel of John, chapter 6, verses 55, 56, that we often overlook. Verse 57 is something that we should also highlight. For Jesus said, my flesh is meat indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He that eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood dwelleth in me, and I in him.
Amen.
As the living Father hath sent me, I live by the Father. So he that eateth me, even he shall live by me. The communion is taken, or is an ordinance that is taken by the Christian church. It is when we acknowledge that his body was broken and his blood was shed for our chances at eternal life. If you are, well, wherever you are, those of you that's all over our cyber campus, we ask you to take your bread now, break, and eat. Likewise, we ask that you take the cup of his blood shed for the remissions of our sins. Drink ye now. Father, we thank you for allowing us to commune globally today with brothers and sisters that we may never meet in the flesh, but you will show us in the spirit. We thank you for who you are. We pronounce healing over those that are in trials right now in their bodies. God, we claim healing right now. We claim it right now because it is already done. In Jesus' name, amen.
Right where you are, if you are in your living room, if you are in wherever your sacred place is, but even in this house tonight, today, worship, why don't you lift your hands to the Lord? Can you play something softly? Lift your hands to the Lord and say something sweet to him. Come on, open up your mouth. Come on. Let him know how much you adore him and you love him. Come on. Let your voice ring out. Make your place a sacred space. Come on, make your space a sacred space. Mention of the name Jesus. Every knee will bow and tongue proclaim. Come on, open up your mouth. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Come on, open up your mouth. Yes, Lord. Come on, tell them I appreciate you. I adore you. I lift your name up high. Come on. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I worship you. I honor you. I appreciate you. Hallelujah. Jesus, Jesus, at the mention of your name, every knee will bow and tongue proclaim. Jesus, yes, Lord, Jesus, hallelujah. You are Savior, you are Lord, and you are God. And if you're in this campus, raise your hands and say, Jesus, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Wonderful Jesus. Have a mention of your name. Every day, Every knee will bow.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah, wonderful Jesus. Yes, Lord, you are Savior, the Savior. You are Lord, and you are God.
You sound real good. Raise your voices, everybody say, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
That sound good. Yes, Lord, Jesus. At the mention of your name.
Yes, Lord.
Every knee will bow.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, Jesus. Wonderful Jesus. Yes, Lord, you are Savior. You are Savior. You are Lord.
Say it, you are Savior.
You are Savior.
I'm going to hit this now. Church now.
You are Savior. You are Lord. You are Savior. You.
Yes, you are Savior, you are Lord.
Yes, Lord. You are Savior, you are Lord.
You are Savior, you are Lord.
And you are God.
I love when they say this part. You're the only God. Say like this.
You're the only living God.
You say it. Yes, Lord. Come on.
The only God.
Thank you, Pastor Smith. Everybody say it. Say it again.
Say you're the only living God.
Come on, say it. You say it. You say it. You're not singing it, but you're singing to the Prince of Peace. Say it again.
Say you're the only living God. Yes, you are.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, you are. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
You're the only living God. Yes, you are.
Come on, everybody. Yes, Lord. Come on, say it.
We love you.
We love you.
We love you.
Yes, Lord.
We love you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
With all of our heart.
Yeah.
We praise you.
Yes, Lord.
We praise you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
We praise you.
We praise you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
We say yes. Look at your neighbor, tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I need to prophesy to you something real quick. God's about to make it happen for you. I think there's somebody just wearing your face and say, he's getting ready to make it happen for me. And I heard the Spirit of the Lord says while I was lying, he says, not many days hence, I'm giving a show of myself strong. But I just need about 17 folk to open up your mouth and give them the biggest hallelujah. If you in your bedroom, if you in your bedroom, don't be ashamed to shake your neighbors and tell them I'm ready. You may pay the ticket and say, neighbor, you just don't know what I have to survive. COVID-19.
Desire to be married was wrong, you just had the wrong fit.
Come on, right. Say so.
All right. You understand? So this is important because to be fit, who fits the vision?
Amen.
Come
who
on.
Fits where you're trying to go? And sisters, you got to be careful because you've been supporting somebody that can't see.
All right now.
Ask your neighbor, say, can't you see? Can't you see? St. John chapter 9. Good to see Brother Joey, Brother Lamar, Pastor Smith, everybody. In respect to the place. I'm reading very quickly. St. John 9, if you're there, shout out there.
There.
If you're still turning, say, hold up. Cool. All right, Bible 4. And Jesus passed by. He saw a man which was blind.
Amen.
From his birth. Somebody shout birth.
Birth.
And his disciples asked him, saying, Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? Jesus answered, neither have this man sinned nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest in him. Let's jump down to verse number 6 for the sake of time. When he had thus spoken, he spat on the ground and made clay of the spittle. And he anointed the eyes of the blind man with the clay. And he said unto him, go wash in the pool of Siloam, which is by interpretation sent. He went his way therefore and washed and came seeing. Somebody shout, came seeing.
Came seeing.
And they was therefore, they which before had seen him that he was blind, said, is not this he that sat and begged? Some said, this is he. Others said, he is like him. Got to take very close note to that. But he said, I am he. I want you to look at your neighbor. If you don't have a neighbor in your house, you can say it out loud if you desire to do it. And say,
it is
an uncommon miracle. Say it again. Say,
it is
an uncommon
miracle.
Can you just get your little ghetto voice on? We got a few folk in here that don't mind getting loud. Football season, get ready to come up. You can't really yell like you want to in the basketball because they're in the bubble. But can you just shout real quick? It is an uncommon miracle. Let me walk this for just a moment. Not going to be for you long, but just for these next few fleeting moments, I want to encourage you. I asked the Lord, what would you have me to say? Understanding that the times that we're in, we are in very precedent times. And so you get great preaching, you get great teaching. But it was his desire that we would minister to the hope because we're in a time that so many need to be revived. And the Spirit of the Lord spoke to me. He said, immediately go to John. John is interesting. And I want y'all to catch me because I don't take a whole lot of time to say what I need to say. I believe people that ramble, apparently they didn't study.
That's very true.
Hello, somebody.
All right.
They just took the time and they're ready to exhort. And exhorting without understanding can oftentimes hype people without causing them to come into a knowledge of what their responsibility is. And so John is interesting, y'all, because John is known as the beloved. He's interesting to the point that he's the beloved, and it was assumed that perhaps he would be the one that would betray Jesus. It was him because he was the one that laid on Jesus' breast. But before John became the beloved, he was what I see some evangelists calling themselves, which is actually incorrect. They call themselves sons of thunder. And you don't understand that sons of thunder in the actual Greek actually means hell raiser. You say, how did he get this name? He got this name because he had a brother by the name of James, and they was hanging out on the fishing dock. It just remind me of myself. I'm a short man. Short men are hot tempered sometimes. Y'all don't want to talk to me again. But see, James got a little something. He got a little squaw with somebody, and he picks the man up, Pastor Lamar, and he slams him on the fishing dock, and the dock begins to rock. And from that, they call him the Son of Thunder. But it's interesting that when Jesus gets a person's heart, he'll take the hellraiser and make him a lover. I need you to do me a favor. I'm going to preach like I feel it. Look at your neighbor. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, you don't even understand. I've spared some folk,
because I love God. There's some people I wanted to cuss out. Y'all want to talk here? There's some people I wanted to show out on, but because I love God. I heard somebody say, I'm going to repeat it. He didn't give it to me, but I'm going to echo it. I thank God for the love of God, because he helped me forgive people I really should have beat up. And if you really know my reputation, some of y'all say, you don't know the old me. I would have showed up to the job, kicked the door over, kicked her out, not talk my mouth, snatched her weed. Y'all don't want to talk to me here. Some of you, you talking the Bible today, but you were some razor token. You didn't do all that talking. You was one of that ones that wherever the fight was, you showed up right. But everybody that come to get food don't want to be spiritually fed. Y'all don't want to talk to me here. So there's a group called the multitude. They want provision, but they don't want sonship. Y'all don't want to talk to me here. At least I feel like preaching to a few of you. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, are you following the ministry? Because you want what's in our hand. But are you following the ministry? Because what the vision is in the house. Everybody want to get fed, but not many people want to grow. Look at somebody across the room and say, it's time to grow up.
That's the Bible saying.
So
there's a multitude. Then there's what you call disciples.
Okay.
Work that.
And disciples are different because they study you.
Students.
Because they see something about their life that you have in you that can help them fix the little dysfunctions.
Yeah. All right.
But they're not sons or daughters.
Right.
They follow you and they will learn your lessons and they will be replicas of what you taught.
That's right.
But they'll never have your spirit. And so here what he does, he says, I gotta talk to the disciples. Disciples come and they see this blind man. Sound like most church folk. Oh, I feel like preaching. Yeah. They want to know, what sin have you committed? The reason why you're suffering. Can I tell y'all something? Everybody ain't living any kind of way. Some of us are trying to live right. Can you do me a favor? I know I'm telling you to talk to your neighbor, but I want to preach all night tonight. Not all night, literally, one day or whatever it is. But we're going to preach like a feeling. Look at your neighbor, tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I know I'm not perfect, but God knows I'm trying to live right. I got a temper, but I'm trying to live right. They have some lust sometimes. They don't want to talk here, but I'm trying to live right. Don't judge me just because my stuff came out. You did what I did. God saw the same thing. You got to be careful. I'm trying to expose what you privately deal with.
Preach
the text. So he comes to the disciples.
Yes, sir.
He comes to the disciples, and here they go like little mercy, messy church folk. What nosy?
Yes, the spirit of nosy. Yes.
Preach. Give me a voice so I can holler. What Jonah did now? Joe, what you done did now? Pastor Smith, what you done did now?
Oh,
talking for whom?
Yes.
Stop judging me by what you heard.
What you heard?
Because what you heard is not my now. Here's what I love about God. He'll deliver you and it ain't got nothing to do with nobody else. And you ain't got to get hands laid on you on the altar. It's when you make up your mind and say, God, I'm tired of this. I know why some people ain't delivered. They ain't tired of what they are. But when you get sick and tired and get sick and tired, don't nobody got to prophesy to you. You get up and shake yourself and say, I'm coming up out of this.
Yes, sir.
He says, they can't find the room on you.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
Maybe it was
your fucking mama be.
Yeah.
Right.
When they can't track your trouble.
Yes.
They try to find your gene.
That's it.
Of dysfunction.
That's it.
Yeah. Well, maybe you ain't in that. Oh, you trying to make your little self a little something. But your mama ain't really been about nothing.
You know? Come on.
So you start trying to discredit your genealogy.
Yes.
There you go.
Yes.
Look at your name. Give us a name. Even if my parents are saved, and even if they're not, when I got saved, the curse stopped with me. I need to talk to some generational cursers and breakers here and say, I know my dad may have been a drunk, but the curse stopped with me. And even if I had a baby out of wedlock, it stopped with this child. This one gonna have a real relationship. It stops with me.
Mercer.
I gotta hurry here.
Praise God.
So he,
take your time, son.
He says to him, he says, neither one of them sinned.
Uh-huh.
To a mess itself.
Yeah.
It ain't gonna take us.
Right.
To a mess itself. To the nose itself.
Yes, sir.
You call yourself prophetic, but you're really a witch.
Come on!
Stop prophesying to me like you heard from God, but you heard my business. And here's how I know you don't know the truth. Because you're telling me what they say, but not what God said. I wish I had somebody here. I need somebody in my life that can see in the spirit. And not seeing me according to what Paul posted about me. Stop seeing what caused the world. Somebody heard. They said, he said. But what did God say? The text.
Yes, sir.
But I'm letting Joe suffer because I'm trying to reveal a work.
That's my
all right.
Thank God.
Anytime I do a work through you, I gotta first do it in you.
Yes.
All right.
Lord, help me here. See, real manifestation of glory is not how you lay hands on somebody to be healed, but it's how you suffer in sickness and hold on to God and got your anointing to heal somebody else. See, what happens is you got to become it before you can deliver it. I need you to do me a favor. Look at somebody and tell us their neighbor. All you've been doing is this season. It haven't been the devil. You get ready to become what I'm getting ready to release. There's another level of ministry. Let's get ready to come. I couldn't make you a millionaire until you was trying to take two nickels and rub it together. I couldn't heal your body until I trusted you with affliction. You gotta become it before you can release it. He says, I did it so I can work in him. Yes. But here's where the text gets interesting. Mm-hmm. Because now, in order to get this miracle, can you imagine being blind? Mm-hmm. And while you're blind, you hear somebody saying, call.
Come on.
Maybe it's just some of your face. I know
there
is. If you that are out there watching right now, can you imagine being in a place where you haven't been able to see somebody saying, they caught me.
Yes, sir.
Y'all are talking here. Wait a minute. I can't see, but what am I hearing? I know what spits sound like.
trying to suggest that when people would spit in your face, it would suggest that it's a curse. But because he's the blessed one, he take that which seemed as cursed and he put it from the origin of what you are and say, I'm going to anoint you in the same way that they cursed you. The very words that talked against you. Lord, help me right here. I'm going to heal you with the very thing that everybody else despises. For such a time as this. ATC says,
Negroology. Yeah.
Some of you would have got out of the spirit. Mm-mm-mm.
Come on now, Mr. Miller. Come on.
Mr. Miller.
Yeah, I
just want to miss. Back up, Jesus.
COVID.
Disciples, stop playing. I can't see now. He says, and he took it.
I love this.
Yes. And he anointed his eyes.
Yes.
The first point that I want to make for you that like homiletic structure, here you go right here. The first point is, are you desperate enough to give? And so what he does is, whatever you got to do, see, you got to get to a point that you got to stop being bougie when you need something from God. You want to say, Lord, can you give me some feed, you water, self for heal something? But when you're tired of being where you are, whatever. For me to get my miracle, if you got the spirit, both of them do what you gotta do. I'm just tired of being blind.
Yes.
First thing is understanding it's okay to be desperate.
Yes.
Number two, he says, go. Pastor, you know, I'm gonna do another thing about you about this because, you know, we have all these. Man, we be talking for a long time about the word, but it'll be funny. It's, man, I'll be
funny. Yes, God.
We stood out there one time. It was about 2 hours. We had to just, Lord have mercy. But I thought about you, Apostle. How is it, Apostle? How can he go wash and he never saw me?
Come on.
See, about 17 of you, when I share this, you're going to feel it in your spirit. You're going to go forth. How? Lady Wings, how could he go? I've never seen before. I know you told me that I'm getting ready to have more than enough, but all I'm used to seeing is dark. I can barely see. I have a genetic issue. I've been born with this, but how can I see it? The reason why I can see it is because I walk by faith and not by sight. And just look across the room and tell them, say, you don't have to see it to believe it. If you can just hear it, it's already yours. I need about a few folk that say, I've been hearing God speak some stuff in my spirit. And no, I don't see it, but I want my faith in.
Lord, help me
hear.
Yes.
God,
yes.
All right.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
But if you ain't got no haters around you, maybe in your living room, even in this church room right here, can you look across the room and say, neighbor, what have you heard in your spirit? What have you said to you lately? I just need to know how many folk God's been telling you, I'm going to make you a millionaire. I need to know how many folk he said, I'm going to bless your business. How many folk in here, I'm getting ready to get healed in my body. How many here that I'm getting ready to give you a brand new job? How many here, I'm getting ready to make you a real business owner? I need you to give God a praise right here, wherever you are. And say, I'm dancing. I can't see it yet, but I hear it in my spirit. Because it's spoken in my spirit, it shall come to pass. He says, now that you see it, what he says, I caught part of your sermon. Mm-hmm. You preach like it was nobody's business. Lord have mercy.
Oh.
But it jumped back in my spirit. He didn't just tell him, go to the pool. Mm-hmm. Here you go. Go wash.
Go wash.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Come on, that's right.
See, washing indicates that you gotta stop worrying about everybody else and start cleaning yourself. But all these church folk trying to tell everybody how dirty they are. Last time I checked, you got dirt, I got dirt. But when we get a hold of Jesus, he said, everybody, just go wash yourself and get yourself together. Because the first person I need to see is me.
Did a great job. Man, you preached it all the way. I felt it in Jacksonville, powerful. But ain't that something interesting though? The path to the pool,
yes,
is actually through Hezekiah's tongue.
Uh-huh.
And understanding that in the tongue is where it's dark.
Dark.
Yes. All
right. Yes, sir. Yes.
Everybody ain't gonna holler right here because you need everybody to be in your face. But I learned, I start praising God because God, I said, I thank you for the people you took out of my life without my permission. I'm so glad for this quarantine because you cleaned up people. I didn't have enough strength to tell them you get on my nerves. I'm sick of you. Don't call me no more. It's time to get all the still people out of your life. Still broke, still petty, still messy, still crazy, still confused, still bipolar, still nasty. Get the still folk out of your life. Look at somebody across the room and say, I have to get the still folk out.
Some of us, we appreciate the quarantine because we're not as drained as we were.
I know that's right. Come on.
Give your last to people who want to give you part of what they
have. That's right.
Y'all want to talk to me here. People will take what I've learned.
That's right.
In ministry, I've been doing it since a little young boy.
Yes, sir.
I've learned everybody don't love you.
Right. Amen.
Some people love what's in your
head,
and they don't care about your heart. And your ministers and preachers that out there, I'm on a rampage to help y'all like never before. That you cannot fall in love with engagements more than you fall in love with God. Because opportunity without character means you'll only be a vessel for a moment, but you won't have sustainability.
Wonderful.
It won't last.
Because
what comes after you being used,
there's
a kryptonite to the Superman.
Yes, yes, yes.
It ain't your power. It ain't your anointing. You understand? Intimacy is so powerful that it makes strong men weak, smart men dumb. It's powerful. He took a man like Samson and didn't give him sex, gave him a lap, and a lap made him lose his position. Be careful about who you connect with.
Isolation.
When I isolate you,
hallelujah.
I gotta tell you something before I leave.
Was left alone.
I don't care, so I can't
say. That's
a little bit. I'm really big on prophetic integrity. We gotta stop filming people getting deliverance.
Amen.
It's disrespectful.
Amen.
Well, you don't know what torments me. Don't make a mockery of what I'm doing.
Come on,
somebody say you can't judge. You can't judge my place. You can't judge my place. You can't judge my place. So here's what he does. I'll put you in isolation. But I want you to go alone. Because on the isolation place is where you're going to find your next level of identity.
Amen.
This is the place that you're going to come into what you heard but didn't see yet.
That's right.
All right, all right.
So before I bless you, I have to strip you.
Yes.
All right.
Before I bless you,
all right,
I have to also break you.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
He says, walks through the tunnel, washes, comes back.
This is
it. The last point for you. I'm amazed at this, Apostle. I'm amazed at this. He comes back,
talk some.
Here go these folk when you get a blessing and start coming up.
Yeah.
they will exaggerate your process.
Yes.
Those are the Bible we just called. He said to them, they said about this man, is this not the one that's been begging?
That's what they said.
He never begged.
Come on.
He was just blind.
That's it. Right. Come on, that's it.
Read the text.
You only had two kids out of wedlock, but they gave you 10.
Yes.
Y'all want to talk to me here?
Yeah. All right, now.
Yes.
Y'all always think, ain't that him? That's the one right there. He's sleeping in on the floor. He the one sleeping on the yard. She the one. She can't. She ain't got nothing to take care of the kids. Don't even know. That's not even my condition. I have something else, but you've exaggerated.
Come on. Come on.
Because I learned that people who are not interested in your transformation, they always want to create something to keep you down.
That's it.
This was so cool.
That's it.
If I had enough more strength, we got to pray. If I had enough more strength, I'll pull it out. What are you going to do? I don't think so. You ready, Joe? Thank you, man. Hit it. He never defended himself.
Mm-hmm.
He just said,
Yes.
The one you've been talking about.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, what's the last point I'm going to make? Don't be afraid to testify. To
Amen.
All right. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Just invite somebody across the room and tell them, say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
The same people.
The same people.
That's been talking about you.
That's been talking about you.
God is keeping them around.
God is keeping them around.
Just so you can testify.
Hallelujah.
Let them live.
Yes.
In the presence.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because I want to show you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, sir.
The destiny is not to you.
Yes, sir.
Destiny is up to me.
Amen.
Be careful who you cast down. They may be the one that need to lift you up next.
That's right.
That's right.
So a lot of times say, don't judge me. Don't judge me.
That's right.
Praise himself for you. Amen. Praise God.
I love it.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Here's what I need you to grasp, because we get happy, but here's the part that makes it holistic for us. When I anoint your eyes to see, you get vision. The problem with most of us is that you're in drama because you don't see nothing better for yourself. Can I be honest with you?
Yes.
When you mature, you don't have time to be discussing a lot about people because you're discussing vision.
Amen.
I need people in my life that are discussing vision. What are we getting ready to do next? What are we getting ready to accomplish? Some of you, God has allowed all of these things to happen because I'm getting ready to birth out of you one of the greatest, hear this, moments of your life.
Amen.
I hear in my spirit, hallelujah, glory to God. Some of you who've been afraid to let people go, God says the time is now, do it. And you don't have much time left. Because listen, the reason why your creativity is being stunted is because you're drained and connected to people who don't want to see you prosper.
Right.
You need intercessors in your circle.
Yes.
Everybody's not happy for your next level.
That's
you
right.
I'm praying for you that you grasp that this next level that God's getting ready to take you.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
He's getting ready to be because you have vision. I didn't just say that I made you see. He said, I he anointed his eyes.
Yes,
when I have the anointing, I don't just see. I see into it.
Amen.
I don't just see. I see into it. It's I see it through the eyes of the Spirit of God.
Yes.
I awaken you.
I love it. Yes.
I alarm you. I empower you.
Yes.
Right in your living room. Right in your restroom. Right in your bedroom. Right in your car. Wherever you are. Friend's house. Neighbor's house. Your boothang house. Shake your boothang down because you may be happy about what God's getting ready to do. But grab boothang. Grab whoever it is and tell them, I now have to see. God's anointing my eyes.
Yes.
Lift your hands all over this room. He's anointing your eyes to see. And whatever condition and place that you're in, whatever place that you've been in, whatever you've been struggling with, I speak to your spirit now that no weapon formed against you shall be able to prosper. Many may be your affliction, but God is delivering you out of all. Father, I thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
That you're healing the broken.
You're helping the heartless. You're strengthening the minds right now.
Yes.
And we thank you for change.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus.
Somebody shout amen.
Yes.
Somebody shout amen.
Amen.